I was born in Mississippi. I was young and running wild. Moved to New York City, where I had my first child. I named the boy Nasir. All the boys call him Nas.
This is Olu Dara. You're watching. This is 50.com. Let me say it again. I messed it up. But
no, that was dope. Okay. That was a good old man way to say it right there.
Come on, tell them about all the places you've gone to.
I've been to Saudi Arabia, Mozambique, yeah, Madagascar, Paris, Greece.
Uh-huh. They say jazz is it's hip-hop.
It's all the same thing, you know. It try to divide things. There's no division when it comes to what we do in the world, you know. Mm. It's all into the same game, you know.
Bridging the gap.
That's all it is.
Mm. And so, man, where did you come from? When did you start doing music? Man, when you start singing and playing the guitar?
Well, I started about over 60 years ago.
60 years ago?
Over 60. See, I'm 72, almost 73, and I started playing professionally when I was 7.
Mm.
And down in Mississippi.
Mm.
What they do is they give you instruments, they go out there and get out of the house and make some money. You know, that's what they do. They don't have no lessons or nothing. You go to the man asks you, you say, do you blow up a balloon? He say, yes, sir. I say, you blow that trumpet, that's like you blow up a balloon. Keep on breathing until you get a sound out. That sound, if I like that sound, join my band. And that's what happened with me. And I played there until I left the hometown. I went to college in Tennessee State, you know.
Mm.
That's where that was a big, big opportunity to know people who have a lot of talent in Nashville, Tennessee at that time. So, and on and on. In those days, everybody had talent, you know.
Everybody.
Everybody had talent. So it was nothing that somebody could do something. Anything, build a house, build furniture, everything. You had to do things like that during that time, especially down south. See?
Mm.
And you had to do something to show what you could do very early in life. Very early. And then your life is okay then. You know, you got something happening, something to offer to people. That's the whole thing. You have to offer. What you got, boy? What you got?
What can you do?
That's what they be talking about.
Right.
What you got, boy? You got to tap dance or do a cartwheel or something.
You got to learn how to rap or play basketball or something, nigga. You're trapped. You are trapped. Either do that or sell crack. That's your only options. That's the only way I've ever seen it work.
So how you get to New York, man? What brought you here?
I was in the Navy. I traveled the world. Africa, Cuba, everywhere. Europe, everywhere. I had done all that in Newport, Rhode Island, and then I wanted to get out of Newport because I only had a couple of niggas in town. You know, I didn't like none of them either.
Right.
So I said, what? I got one more year to do in the service. And black people there, they said, only Chicago and New York. And New York was closer to Newport. I had a friend who drove, and we came to New York. I did my last year in the military in New York, out in Brooklyn, you know, in the Navy. And next thing I know, I didn't want to leave New York because it was just so different, you know. And right now, it's like cool right now, but then it was like, you know.
It was popping.
Man, let me tell you everything happening now. I'll tell you, anything you want to do, you can do it right here in 1 second, just like that. Everything was jumping, you know what I mean? Jumping here, jumping there, jumping there. Brooklyn was really jumping. Harlem wasn't that popping at the time.
What?
Not during that time. It was just trying to do a little thing. But Brooklyn was the thing that was happening in those days.
Mm.
See, everything was happening was all the jazz, Brooklyn.
Mm.
You know, everything was happening. Sports, James Brown, Gladys Knight, hip hop, all kinds of things right over in Brooklyn. Mm. And it finally eased up in Harlem a little later on, mm. You know. And Brooklyn was a place to be at that time. And I came to New York just to have another life. And I had another life here, see.
How many children you got?
About
children?
Yeah, about that many.
Yeah, wow. That's right. Wow, that sounds like more than 11.
Yeah, that's right. About that many. And they all cool, too.
Word. You got some young children, too, dog.
Yeah, they got young. My youngest one is right there. He's the one that brought me to you. That one right there, boy, right there.
He's magical.
That's right.
Yo, he's a really special dude right there, man.
He's real cool. He introduced me to you.
He introduced me to you.
See, he introduced me to his mother.
You understand?
What?
He introduced me to his mother.
Hold on, time out. Yeah. Your son introduced you to his mother.
That's right. That's right. That's why his mother looks strange right now. When you meet the son's mother through your son, that's a hell of a thing.
That's amazing right there.
Work with that. Work with that.
Hey, I'm going to dissect
that.
I'm
going to work with that.
Get, wow.
Work with that. But, you know.
That's a bad mother.
That's right. That
he just wanted to be happy. You really care about your mama, boy.
You did?
Whoa. Is he your favorite?
Look at it. Let me say this to the public. This is my favorite because he's my youngest and he's the hippest one.
What?
Now, I'm a little confused about something. Your name. Yeah. Olu Dara.
Yeah.
You don't seem, that seem like an African name. You don't seem African.
You know why I don't seem African?
Why?
Because I'm American. I got his name through Africans. It means God is good. That's what all it means. God is good. Mm. Yeah, but I got it from traveling in Africa when I was, how old was I then? 20 years old.
What does Nas's name mean?
Helper and protector.
Nas, like what kind of guy is him? You know him on a whole nother level. Nobody else don't know him. How would you describe?
You know what, he was interesting, very interesting, you know. He was real cool. He grew up with his brother, Jungle Jabari. They grew up together. When mother moved to Queensbridge, and she was trying to divorce me then, and then she said, I'm gonna move to Queensbridge, and I'm gonna get me a job doing that. And you won't have to work that much or something like that. Could you come out and help me? I was happy because I thought she had broken up with me really for good, and I wasn't going to see the boys like I wanted to. And I went out to Queensbridge, and there they were. And I said, go downstairs, because the mother said, don't let the boys outside. It's too dangerous out here. And I said, when she left that day, I told the boys, I said, your mother's not here, so go downstairs, get your ass kicked, because I know it's going to happen. Go downstairs, they were like daycare age at the time. I looked out the window, watched them. As soon as they walked downstairs, a whole bunch of guys gathered around them, you know, popped them around the head a few times. And Jungle didn't talk at all. He didn't talk until that day. I saw him down there getting beat around. They started to cry, they came back upstairs. And the mother came in and said, what's going on? You let those boys downstairs? I said, yeah, they went at the ground and find what life is really like out here. And they went down and they got beat around. And Jungle, the first thing he ever said out of his mouth, and he must have been 3 years old, he said, I'm gonna kick them motherfuckers all up in there.
At 3 years old, I'm gonna kick them motherfuckers all in their ass.
That's the first thing I ever heard him say. And he's the same way today, I see.
Today. Yeah. I'm going to kick them motherfuckers all in their ass to this day.
That's what he said.
Because every time I see him on like the VH1 specials and everything, mm-hmm. and when they speak of Jungle, it's a very serious vibe go on.
Well, he's serious. I do remember when Nas first came out on his label doing something, and they were harassing Nas as he drove around in a truck. Some of his boys were driving around certain neighborhoods out in Queens. They wanted to bother him, you know, because they of a certain type of jealousy or whatever. And all he had to do was call Jungle. Or Jungle would be there, and then it's all over, you know. Mm-hmm. And he's a great, great child himself. That the kids had dyslexia. In our class, I was a compulsive sketcher of teachers in my homeroom. I drew pics to mess them up, cause none of them would like my style. Read more books than the curriculum profile. Said, Mr. Jones, please come get your child, cause he's writing mad poems and his verses are wild. I was born in Mississippi.